Hi everybody, I'm Jim.
And I'm Rich.
And we're playing Resident Rise.
Yeah.
Rich is chowing down.
Yeah, I'm chowing down, and we discovered Jim's crossbow is bigger than mine.
We should go check on that glass while Franklin is coordinating
yeah,
some more stuff. We finished the first room, but we're gonna need a. I want to use a pretty big room for this, because we can also get into things like auto crafting. So let's go check on that glass. Hardened glass.
While he's doing that, I am about to go place down dispensers and work on this. I just need to move something to my other monitor first, and full credit of this goes to Riskable of, you know, look up Riskable builds on YouTube. This guy's got some great builds for mana and stuff, Batania stuff, various other things. I'm rambling.
It's alright.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3.
So we need glass for the servo.
Okay, it's poppers.
Along with electrum.
So yeah, as people are noticing, I prepared a lot of the basic stuff for this ahead of time. I hope I got everything prepared ahead of time.
I believe in you.
But I've still got some Batania stuff that will need to be made. Flowers, things like that.
I keep looking around being like, where's all my silver? And then realizing that
it's in the storage system.
No, that I basically have been not mining silver for a while.
Because
I just
mining.
Didn't have... Well, I didn't have a use for it, and it was just going to clutter everything up. But now that I have a use for it, I'm like, where's my silver? Where is it? But you're right that some of it is certainly in the silver, in the storage system.
Yeah, of course I broke my Matic. Get that repaired.
I love this new jetpack.
Okay.
It's my new best friend.
Oh, constantly being replaced.
It's okay. I didn't replace you. Jetpack.
Okay, now to see if I can remember how to do this properly.
Gold. Get some pulverized silver. Let's go make some electrum.
Should look like that. Like that. Yeah, that's looking good. Back.
How many do we need for this? We just need two, so
video.
We're gonna make a few servos.
Redstone time. I built this before, but I'm trying to remember how I did it at the time.
I understand. I have those moments where I'm like, okay, I remember doing this.
Well, part of it is the video I'm using is kind of backwards to how I'm looking at everything.
Oh?
Yeah, so I think it was here.
And we're gonna need some tin.
Because I plan to put the furnace and stuff here. So this corner here should. Oh, right. Wait, no, I don't want that in the dispenser.
So what are you doing?
I'm building a contraption.
For the uninitiated. A contraption?
Sure, sounds good. I'm building actually a mana farm that's gonna ultimately use baked potatoes.
Okay.
And I say ultimately because it's going to take a while to get to that point. Oh, nope, I did get it wrong. Okay.
Some item ducks.
He put
and we're gonna shove there. A bunch of things into the storage system. Because that's what it's for. So now we've got item ducts and servos and a dolly. Franklin's still chiseling this bit out. Have to go back to the end soon. Or the nether, rather. Because we're running out of blaze rods. And I don't want to tap us out, which is why I haven't made more ender chests.
Okay, so that looks about right.
Are these... Okay, they are complete. So let's take this.
He's doing something different than what I'm working on at the moment. Darn it. Oh well.
Now, we're going to take these item ducts and use them to attach.
I'll probably need these rooms again later.
The chests. But we're going to do two because we're nerds. Because we have two servos.
What if I don't want to be a nerd?
It's too late.
Oh. I didn't get notified.
So ignore. Stack size is 64. So now it clears it out a stack at a time.
Woohoo!
Puts it in the ender chest. And it goes from the ender chest into the storage system. Look at that. Now all we need to do is get the other chests and bring them over here.
Let's grab some more of these materials. I think we need these things soon.
Look at that go.
What are you? You. Over
chests
here.
Upstairs.
Plus more potatoes because it's gonna need a crap ton of potatoes.
So you're turning potatoes into mana?
Yes. What, you don't expect me to eat them, do you?
You know, the thought had crossed my mind.
What kind of crazy talk's that?
Look, I don't know. I'm not an expert. Look at that go. I'm not going to clean out all my chests today, but we've got new, fresh storage space in the workshop, and because of the crafting terminal, it means we can...
craft things as long as it's in the storage.
Yep. Now, there is a downside.
There is?
Well, there is.
I mean, other than power usage.
And the fact that a creeper just blew up behind me.
Was it a regular creeper?
A creep, which is those creeper spider things. Two of them, actually.
Yeah, don't
everything's,
we just want more of those things.
Everything's fine.
So just because I want this to look a little different, I'm going to make a slight change to...
Just hanging out in our poorly lit basement.
Not my fault.
No, I'm aware. I'm currently digging down here.
Didn't do it, wasn't me, you can't prove anything.
I agree. I am literally excavating in the basement right now. This is the perfect time for monsters to turn up.
Okay, as long as I'm not getting blamed, we're all good.
No, it's not your fault, man.
I'm not used to hearing that.
Some things aren't your fault. We'll fix the floor a little later, because I gotta make some more blocks.
Some things aren't my fault. A lot of things generally are.
Well, whose fault is that?
My brother's.
I would say that it's literally yours.
No, it's blame Rob Day.
Nope.
Yep.
Alright.
Blaming him.
So we're gonna need to move the sword system into here.
Okay, rails placed.
And we're gonna need to move the interface up to the workshop.
And of course, I put the hoppers away and forgot them.
First thing I need to figure out is where do I want this interface to be in the workshop?
On the left.
Shut up.
Fine.
You're no help.
Fine, be that way.
I am being that way. So we can put it along the back wall. Or next to the stairwell, but I think we're going to want it right here. And we're going to accomplish that by using conduit facades to make things look nice. So we need to tunnel from here into the basement.
That just literally destroyed. Nope, okay.
Now it's time to get out the hammer.
It's hammer time.
It is super hammer time. I'm so close to burrowing into the basement here. Cable down here. And ideally, we want to run this right the first time.
Well, ideally, yes. This doesn't mean it's going to happen.
Oh, of course not. But ideally, that's what we want. Through to here and figure out where this needs to go. While we're doing that, let's start building.
So some explanations for the weird things people are seeing me do right now.
What are they seeing you do? I have no idea.
Yeah.
Like, usually when you say that, you're like throwing people into a smelter, I hope.
You know, let me go get my golden lassos, and we can get...
No!
I thought you finally changed your mind.
You're
so
wrong.
So, let me just go harvest these potatoes real quick, and then I'll give a bit of an explanation. So, what's been going on here is I've been setting things up, obviously. The rails run around the corners. They're going to go along here, and over top these hoppers, obviously. This, you know, minecart chest here, when it's full of potatoes and it travels over top of the hoppers, will deposit the potatoes into the hoppers, which then feed into the dispensers. These two detector rails, when they go off, will then tell the dispensers, hey, give them a redstone signal, say, hey, shoot out some potatoes. They'll shoot out their potatoes, and they'll, you know, land on the farmland and plant themselves, which, they will grow. Over here, I've got a redstone comparator set up so that if there's anything in the hopper when the minecart gets here, it will turn off the booster track so that the minecart will stay there until it's filled from the hopper. The chest above the hopper, of course, where the potatoes will go, and I've got an item frame on there with a potato in it because I'm going to use a hopper hawk flower to collect all the harvested potatoes and put them in the chest. And with the item frame on there with the potato on it, it'll only pick up and put in potatoes. That's the point I'm at right now. Have we learned that something?
Kind of.
Good.
And all of this makes mana?
Eventually. I still got a lot more setup to do.
No.
I mean, I haven't even set up the process for baking the...
Sorry, what I meant by that is, Rick, we need mana now. Why are you not doing it right now? What are you possibly doing?
I'm making up a more efficient one to go with the mana I set up.
So what you're saying is that some things take time and it's important to just be patient?
Well, I could do it off camera and have it done already, but you keep wanting me to show things how they're done.
but we have this show that we do.
Well, I thought that was just the, you know, we kill each other show.
No, that's a different show.
Oh, okay.
We can do that show if you want, though.
So now, skipping along with this video, I know how all this other stuff works.
Alright.
It's time to start setting up other stuff to get prepared.
So, turtles are building another room while they're doing that.
Pulse mana spreader.
We're going to figure out like how we want to power this. Because ideally, I only want to have one cable that runs out through here.
Wait, did I not make that of the mana pool I needed? I thought I had. Oh, there it is.
So we're going to do some digging with the hammer. That's why we made the hammer.
Shears still, Jim? Throw them in the
Oh yeah, totally. They're in my tool bag.
Okay, I'll just make some new shears. I need to go get some grass.
I need some dense cable.
Are you sure?
Yep.
It's gonna be interesting when I get around to tapping into that system.
Why?
Because I'll have to run the cables for that.
Oh, I'm going to run you cables, don't worry.
Well, I don't even have a tower set up yet.
What do you mean a tower?
My mage tower for when I go and
start doing alchemy
and stuff like that and want to store my ascension in the storage system.
That is why I'm running dense cables instead of smart cables.
Yeah, well, I figure I'll wire all that in because why not?
I don't know. Why not?
I can't really think of a reason, but I'm going to be running the cables at the tower anyway, so...
Yeah, we didn't build an excavator.
Just thinking of it, I probably should have grabbed more than just the one grass, but... You know, those birds are pissed.
What's that?
Oh, the cockatrices.
Oh, I bet. So we're basically running it under the back corner.
I see the problem here.
Okay, so we're actually going to run it one level deeper so that we can have full blocks between here. There's a whole bunch of stray blocks in here we're not going to worry about for right now.
Now there's a bit faster way to do this. First, we sleep.
We are going to make sure that no monsters spawn.
Yeah, good. Actually, now I think about it, well, I might not that. I need a, offering hourglass. Pardon me.
Okay, so now there's cable that runs up from the workshop. Into the storage area. We've got that right here. So let's one, hop up, pop a torch in there, and two, put the rest of this cable in.
Operating hourglass complete. So, for anybody watching, assuming Jim's showing what I'm doing,
I'm totally showing what you're doing, man. Jeez, there's no trust.
Of course not. I just made a hovering hourglass. What that'll do is, once I load it with the appropriate sand, in this case, sandstone, or not sandstone, soul sand, it'll essentially set a timer on this thing. I think soul sand is 1 minute per soul sand, and so after the minutes are up, the hourglass will flip over, resetting itself, and it'll give a redstone signal to the pulse mana spreader, which will then shoot a pulse of mana out to hit an item I am about to make, if I can remember. Ooh. The materials.
I am going to move storage system phase one into the first storage room. After dumping some stuff into it. Okay.
We need to make some more living wood soon. A couple leather.
I'll leave the discs where they are.
Oh,
for
yeah.
Now.
As you can see, I renamed a couple of these NPCs so Jim would quit being mad at me. We now have Carl and Marcus.
It's translation, I got those NPCs killed and they're dead now.
I knew something happened to them.
What?
I knew it couldn't have truly been regular mobs that killed them.
No, as in, I am putting words in your mouth because that's what happened to those poor ass NPCs.
Blah, 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 blah. You killed them.
Now,
I know it.
Note that, of course,
of the wild,
as is tradition, the power cables invariably sit completely opposite the actual storage system also. Turns out that the power cables are inside the storage system. shit happens. Just hooking it up to throw a terminal on it.
So yeah, this is going along pretty good right now. I still need to make the hopper hawk and a few more flowers. Well, quite a few more flowers because I need some. One of the other things going to get set up right here in the middle. A flower called the Egg of Carnation. It will take mana from the mana pool over here. And down here, it will then use that mana to make all the potatoes grow faster. So the potatoes should go from planted to maturity within the 4 minute timer that I would be setting up to set off that Drum of the Wild.
Doesn't that sound so cool?
So, You basically made speed potatoes?
Essentially.
Okay. Speed potatoes, I gotcha. Picking up what you're putting down. Why?
Why speed potatoes?
Like, I assume because speed potatoes turn into mana.
Yeah, I'll be turning everything into mana, and the faster they grow, the less time I have to wait to get the baked potatoes to turn into mana.
That makes sense.
Of course it does. Got time to get at the furnace. Where did I put the furnace? It's a furnace.
Still probably going to move these things around in here a bit, but for now, we'll go energy acceptor, dense energy cell. Where's my dense cable?
Okay, I've got the track run.
Hmm?
I'm semi-mumbling to myself, semi-mumbling
to
the people watching. Send the minecart off. Oh, got up in one shot. It'll come around because I have nothing to go with.
Ah!
I didn't do it.
I know you didn't do it. There's more friggin' creepers. Just scared the shit out of me, is all. And before you ask, yes, the basement is lit. Most of it.
Mostly? It's this way it needs to be placed. Yeah.
Alright. I hear you, skeleton. At least we didn't lose anything important. Scared the shit out of me. So, interface terminal top. Pattern terminal. Crafting terminal. And now we're gonna go get the a pain in the butt to move, eh? I wish you could move them with a dolly.
That would make it much easier.
But I mean, for the work that they do, I suppose I really can't complain.
Well, sure you could.
Okay. So now all our storage is inside the room. And with a little bit of cable, we'll be able to connect that to the workshop.
I think I've got this mostly done. Other than the plants I need.
We're going to run it underneath the floor. How much dense cable do I have? But, and I'm using dense cable because it'll hold 32 channels, so it'll pass more data. And it'll mean that, Rick, when you want to hook up your wizard tower, we've already got dense cable running out to that area. So we won't need to rerun the cable. Now we're going to mix colors because I'm a monster.
Wait, why are you mixing cables other than being a monster?
No, that's basically it. So, all hooked up. Let's grab an interface. Terminal. We're also going to grab some cable anchors. And some stone. Head back up to the workshop. While carefully checking that the basement is lit. Which it is. So.
Stone. Do I need another hopper for this? And that's apparently have to be done more.
Now we're going to make some cable facades. Network aesthetics. Cute. So my interface goes in here. Like that.
And of course I'm shy of hopper.
We'll put that on the outside as well. So you're gonna need a couple more. But we'll fix that next time. Well, I am gonna come over and see what you're doing.
Oh, okay.
Oh, that looks elaborate.
It is elaborate.
Sounded elaborate.
It looks elaborate.
I'm glad we're all in agreement.